Douglas Cooling and Heating, serving the Birmingham area for 38 years. 988-3706. That's Douglas.
I'm James Spann. This is the afternoon edition of the Weather Xtreme video for Tuesday, the 2nd of November, Election Day. Some parts of the state getting rain, other parts just cloudy. And later on, we've got some cold air settling in here by the end of this week and the weekend. Let's take a look at some of the image. Pouring rain in Fayette up in the northwestern part of the state. That is certainly one of the wet spots now. Been raining steadily there for much of the afternoon. Up the road in Hamilton, there's a look at the Hamilton High School football stadium. Light rain is falling there. And that shot there in Russellville tells the story, doesn't it? Russellville is up in Franklin County in northwest Alabama. And that's clearly where the best rain is falling now from about Tuscaloosa and Reform up into that part of the state. Pretty good looking storm system winding up there. Strong upper low developing over Texas. Convection down into the Gulf. Big old comma-shaped cloud, and that thing will be meandering west of the state in the short term. And again, it looks like the heaviest rain will stay west of Alabama. Temperatures mostly in the 60s. The warm spot, Montgomery at 73. These are 2 o'clock observations. We've got Birmingham and Gadsden at 64. Tuscaloosa, 63. Tomorrow might be a bit cooler. We could stay in the 50s much of the day with clouds and some light rain. And around the southeastern states, look at the wedge, cold air damming over Georgia. Readings there only in the 50s. That's trying to nose into extreme northeast Alabama, but we're pretty much in a tongue of milder air here. And it's cooler back off to the west. Look at Dallas-Fort Worth. They're sitting at like 52 with the upper low right over them. They have dynamic cooling and clouds and rain going on there. So kind of cool air all around us, but we're really the warm spot across the deep south today. There's the radar at 219. That's about what we expected. That's jives up nicely with the output of the RPM and some of the other modeling. And again, you can see that good rain over Pickens, Lamar, Fayette, Marion counties. You go east of I-65, you got nothing for Anniston and Gadsden. And again, we clearly think the best rain totals will be on that western side of the state through midweek. Don't expect any severe weather. In fact, that's the convective outlook for today and tonight, just the low-end 5% probabilities over the central Gulf Coast, and that's just a small chance. Elsewhere, the air is cool and stable. And there's the QPF chart, the expected rain, valid through Sunday morning at 7 o'clock. Biggest numbers over Louisiana and parts of Mississippi. Alabama, the heaviest rain should be down over the Gulf Coast, Mobile and Baldwin counties, and the amounts taper off by the time you reach the Tennessee state line. Barely enough to measure there. And we're hoping that Birmingham might pick up a half inch, and for Anniston and Gadsden, we're talking maybe a quarter to 1/2 inch. Not a big rain event, but again, we'll take whatever we get. Tropical weather, Tomas in the Caribbean. That's a big old mass of storms, not particularly well organized. The top winds are at 50 miles per hour. Moving west at 10, that thing's going to take a hard turn to the right in about 36 hours. The guys at the Hurricane Center have it up as a minimal hurricane, then coming across Haiti, where you don't want to see that, but looks like it's going to go right over that island nation Friday or Friday night, and then move northeast on out into the open Atlantic late this weekend. And again, as we've talked about for days, this is no threat to the United States mainland. We'll check the modeling. This is the 12Z GFS, valid at 1 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. Upper low is centered just below Lake Charles, right around the Sabine Pass on the Gulf Coast. Strong energy diving down the northern branch of the jet. And down below all that, obviously, it's going to be cloudy and cool, and we'll see some rain at times. Mostly light rain. Don't think it'll be especially heavy. And again, because of the clouds, we could be in the 50s much of the day. Both the GFS and the NAM are showing a high in the low 60s, but it's going to be a cool, cloudy, and kind of a damp day. Now, Thursday, the upper low kicks out. It's becoming absorbed by the upper trough that's forming over the east. Any rain will be ending really early Thursday morning. I'm talking maybe 3, 4, 5 o'clock in the morning. And the sky becomes partly sunny. A north wind kicks in. We'll probably reach the low 60s, but then on Friday, look at the trough over the east. Yow! That's cold. And again, the axis a little east of here. There's the thickness values, the 540 line down to Montgomery. Strong north winds. Look at the gradient there. It's going to be a sunny day, but a breezy and cold day. I think we'll be in the 40s much of the day, probably maybe easing up to the low 50s, but it will feel like we'll be in the 40s because of that strong wind. Saturday, the wind dies down. That's going to set the stage for the first widespread freeze of the season Saturday morning. Lows between 27 and 32 are quite likely. And really, Sunday morning can be just as cold. Again, we'll be down there in the low 30s, so look out for a freeze. Both mornings, highs on Saturday should be in the middle 50s, close to 60 by Sunday as we start to warm up, and then Monday of next week hit the mid-60s. And there's Tuesday, and we stay dry and comfortable. A few days later on the 12th, now, you know, this is interesting that we've got all kind of model madness out here. The consistency is not good in model output, making for a low-confidence forecast. Now, a warm ridge over the southeast, a big cold trough out west, and all of the action with that cold front stays north and west of the state as we are under the ridge. So all of a sudden, the rain chances have diminished on this run on the 12th. And then on the 16th of November, you know, the maps I showed you this morning had a big thunderstorm event with cold air flooding in behind it. Well, that's gone. We've got ridging now in a big trough out west and very strong westerlies north of the state. And again, that looks dry. So that's why this is voodoo land. Everything comes and goes, but remember, this is tornado season, and wouldn't be shocked if we saw another big storm on the board at some point out there toward mid-month. And on the 18th, the ridge holds on this run. The big trough is out west, so obviously confidence in any specific solution out there at mid-month is very, very, very small. That's it for the Weather Xtreme video today. We'll have notes on the blog, the next video here by 7 o'clock tomorrow morning. And if you're local to us, we invite you to watch us on television this evening, ABC 3340 in Birmingham at 5, 6, and 10. Thanks for watching. Have a great evening and God bless.
Each day there are new stories to tell about the people who live here and the place we call home.
All of the faces that I see, all of the places close to me, they're all
sharing your stories on ABC 3340, Alabama's news leader.